So I'm Matt Baker, and my paper was over acrylic-based photopolymers. So the article I researched was titled Acrylic-Based Photopolymer for Two-Photon Microfabrication of Photonic Application, and it was in the Advanced Functional Materials in February 2005. So it's an older article. But basically, the scope of it was to improve 3D resolution associated with photopolymerization fabrication. Because right now, that was a big thing. It's just the actual resolution of what you're creating. So what this paper was looking into is what are the properties of an L1-N1 resin on a nanoscale. L1-N1 is a developmental resin at least at the time the paper was written. So the materials that were used for the study were the L1-N1 resin, which is created by all the parts in this table here. And then SCR-500 resin, which was a resin made at the time, but it wasn't commercially available. So they're looking to make a more commercially available version. So for the study, the process conditions that were examined were the photopolymerization response, different properties than the thermal stability of the actual resin. And to do this, they used a TI PhotoDSC Q1000, which is just a photo differential scanning calorimeter, and then a thermal gravimetric analyzer to do the thermal stability study. So from the photopolymerization effects on the material, graph A, it studied the different photo initiator effects. So if you had what happens with your different concentrations of photo initiator inside the L1-N1 resin. And what the study found was that if you had higher concentrations of the photo initiator, you would get a higher rate of polymerization from the photopolymerization. To do this, they used 1% weight, 1.5% weight for the L1-N1, and then they also compared it to the SCR-500. Graph B, which is in your upper right-hand corner, shows the effects of the light intensity used. And from this study, it showed that the higher the light intensity, you can basically control the rate of polymerization. Higher light intensities will create quicker, as you can see. But what happens is all the photopolymerization takes effect in the first 10 to 15 seconds, which is what you're looking for. And then the third part was the temperature effect. So what it was really looking for was what happens for the decomposition rate for each type. So at higher temperatures, higher temperatures resulted in a higher initial polymerization rate. So everything happened more rapidly at the beginning if you had a higher temperature. And this was, for this study, they mainly just looked at the 1.5 L1-N1 just because of the previous studies they could determine that at that weight, you had better initial concentrations and better light intensity. So the second study just looked at the thermal stability of the material, and what the study gathered was that the L1-N1, or the L1-N1, had a slower decomposition rate than the SCR-500. So it looked at what temperature that the actual material would start to break down, and the max temperature that the rate became too great. So for the L1-N1, or the L1-N, that rate started around 350 degrees Celsius and then peaked at around 400 degrees, whereas the SCR-500 peaked at around 127 and then just took off around 200. And at the same rate that the SCR-500 did, the L1-N1 at 273 degrees was drastically lower. And then they also looked over a brief, long period of time, and what they found was over 4 hours at 150 degrees, Celsius, the LN1 was very thermally stable. So the key conclusions from the result were that the LN1 resin actually satisfied most of the requirements for SLA on microscale or nanoscale, and that it had fast cure times with simple fabrication conditions. And another one was that it could withstand temperatures of 150 degrees for long periods of time with a decomposure rate that started around 340 degrees Celsius. My personal critique of the paper was, in the paper they would discuss the needs for good mechanical properties and elongation and minimal stream fringe and stuff, and they discuss that, they talk about it in the actual conclusion, but they never actually talk about it really in the paper besides the initial thing that they need these type of properties. They just said, hey, we need these. And also, it doesn't discuss if this new resin was actually commercially available, but just says developmental. So is this resin going to be better suited than the SCR 500 if it's not commercially available?